I think we can do better. And here's how I can think we can do better. Again, I'm taking the Voosh approach. Here's how I think we can do better. Okay? Right now, we're here. Actually, you know what? Now we're about here at, like, crony late-stage capitalism. Do you think there would be less interest? Yes, I think there would be less interest in communism. If there was, you know, less people on the streets. But the way things work now just shows you how vast the inequality is and how much capitalism doesn't work. I mean, here's a spectrum, I guess. Right here, we're at, you know, late-stage crony capitalism. Brush. With, like, a building and a hierarchy and a triangle. And, like, the poor sleep outside and eat out of dumpsters. About 60,000 people. 600,000 people. Even though we have millions of homes. Here's what I want. I want us to move further and further left. Till we eventually get to, like, a gift economy. Everyone gets a house, everyone gets food. So here's how I think we start. I think we start by taxing the rich. You know? And giving that money to the poor. And not even just taxing the rich. Don't you think you could solve some of the problems with socialism? Yes. So socialism is an economic question. Is an economic philosophy. It's true that socialism can fix a lot of these problems. And when a big business fails, basically also I want, like, regulation in place and stuff in place. So where when a big business like Strex Corp or whatever fails, it can then become a horizontal business where the employees now run the company. So what we do is we tax the rich, give the money to the poor, introduce a model where employees can run businesses after they fail, after they do too many stock buybacks and something happens. All their assets become co-opt. And about here is where I want a huge social safety floor, as I like to call it. A social safety floor. Now, some of these aren't my ideas. What if employees don't want to run a business? Look, you can be a factory worker and still vote on how the business works. You can still be a factory worker and still vote on how the business works. So, right about here, like, I want to move. I don't want a revolution. I want to move continuously to the left. And I want, you know, right about here is where we should introduce a giant safety floor. Big, huge. Everyone gets a, every homeless person gets a house. gets a roof over their head. Every one of them gets a roof. All right. What else? Yeah. Roof? Maybe even UBI. Maybe even UBI for everyone. And then further, after this, you know, a roof probably about here, UBI probably about here. And after that, yeah. After that, you know, we get, you know, extra stuff. You know, the stuff that, yes, yes, we get more and more based. After we give a roof to every homeless person and UBI to everyone. After all that happens, then we can decommodify everything. Free sex, free basing. Giant trampoline would be better. How would you know how to run a factory? Look, I don't know how to run a factory, but I'm sure the workers do. In fact, worker cooperatives have been proved to be more successful. Food. Healthcare. All right. Healthcare. Food. After we provide a roof to everyone by taxing the rich and giving money to programs that help poor people like these. And somewhere around here, we're gonna need to support worker cooperatives. Yeah, so we need to support co-ops and worker cooperatives. What stops the rich to moving to a country that they aren't taxed? We take away their yachts. You can't leave the US right now. We melt down their yachts. We take parts from their yachts. And we build solar panels with them. Yeah, that's the problem. What does CHS Inc. do? So, we support startups, we support co-op startups and existing co-ops. Any place and big sweeping changes to our what is that thing called? It's agriculture co-op. Interesting. That's pretty based. Agriculture is pretty based. Farmers are really based, guys. I'm a big fan of farmers. I want all the farmers to get nice things. So here's the thing. So here's what we do is we stop those companies from being able to do business in the US if they don't want to be taxed. We literally can just stop them from doing business inside the United States if we... I mean, so this is my idea. This might take generations. So, I mean, here we are now. What we really need to do before any of this, is have big sweeping climate change reform. So, look, a lot of people are like, fine, stopping here. But, which is, you know, it's good. I really don't know. You know? I really don't know. I'm new to this. This is what I want. Really? This right here? This right here? This doesn't even stop big companies from existing. This doesn't even stop big companies from existing. But you'll never be able to tax money from the rich. They are rich for a reason. They are rich for no reason. They are rich for no reason. I'm drawing the proletariat. I'm drawing our plan. Guys, this is our plan. This is our master plan and master agenda, where gift economy is over here. And over here is garbage capitalism. So, because it's been an hour and in 30 minutes, I just want to say how thankful I am for everyone that's here right now, and how much time and effort that I put into streaming, and how much time and effort I put into creating content. So if you would like to help, do you not think I know that? And because we live in a capitalist society, I need your donations to keep going, and I need your donations to, this is how I would like to build my society. Anti-consumerism. The issue, okay, so what do you mean by anti-consumerism? Like, as in, oh, are we talking about, like, okay. So once upon a time, there was a light bulb manufacturer. We need a king and queen. We're not the UK. We don't need a fake king and a fake queen. I don't know how to draw a light bulb. So get this. Light bulbs are actually anti-consumer. A long time ago, they basically became
You sound strange.
Hang on, let me research this real quick. I guess I won't have a source for this, which is big yikes. But yeah. Wait, you're talking about consumerism and as economics, not science? Well, I mean, here's the thing. The issue is, see, there we go. The issue is, light bulb companies basically came together and they're like, fuck consumers. They went, we're gonna max out our life bulb, the lifetime of light bulbs to 1K, to 1,000 hours. Well, yeah, I think it was 1,000 hours. Do you know what that's called? It's called a fucking mafia, bro. Yeah, this is my understanding of anti-consumerism. Edison conspiracy. Yo, fuck Benjamin Franklin and fuck everyone but Nikola Tesla. But fuck Elon Musk too. Elon Musk is garbage. Garbage man. So So this that's my understanding of anti-consumerism. But if you would explain to me anti-consumerism, you're more than welcome to. I'm always willing to learn. But your take on economics is a bit I heard you said just like print money, and I went, what? No. Did you read your message on anti-consumerism? That's my understanding. Pretty sure anti-consumerism is an idea being against a society that pushes everyone to constantly consume and buy products. No, I mean, that's not... So my understanding of... is what I just did. What I just showed you. Where all the light bulb manufacturers came together. Look, I'm in streaming right now, Anarcho Commu. But if we're talking about that, if we're talking about anti-consumerism as in being against consuming products, look, I'm for that. For the most part. Hang on, this should just be background noise. I'm all for that. Because here's the thing that capitalism has done. It's created piles and piles of junk. Of just junk that no one uses. Have you ever seen those as on TV ads? For products that just go into waste bins and dumps, like, 2 seconds after you open them? I'm sure some of them are fine. But some of them are, or knockoff iPods that are purposely terrible. That's what I want to avoid. Is piles and piles of junk just landing up in China. Right, right. And here's the thing about a phone, right? Your phone in your pocket, right? It should last 5 years. At least. But here's the caveat with battery replacement. About 3 years in, you probably need a battery replacement. And I'm actually... Guys, I have a pile of e-waste. Like, if there's any topic that I'm actually capable of talking about, it's e-waste. But instead, they come out with a new product every year. And how long's your contract? It's 2 years. Your contract is probably 2 years. And then they'll probably finance another replacement phone. There's also been an issue of Apple literally slowing down phones. Apple slowed down phones when new ones came out. And they literally said it was for battery reasons. So my question is, if they're worried about it, if you're worried about the environment, why are you coming out with new products every year? That's another issue with capitalism. Right, they put expiration dates on most products. The ideal solution is to make sustainable products profitable. So the issue is sometimes they aren't profitable. I don't think it's profitable for iPhones to come out with a new iPhone every 2 years instead of every 1 year. I mean, they can try it. And it's Apple, so they'll probably get away with it. But some of the issue is they're literally like, you can't replace this battery. You know, only our specialized service providers can use our specialized battery and our specialized phone with our special 5-pointed screws. If you care about your products being repairable, yes, it's called planned obsolescence. And it's one of the issues with capitalism. And it's one of the reasons that we don't have that many protections. You love a good multifaceted screw. Look. Screws suck. On the iPhone, there are too many screws. Let me show you how small an iPhone screw is. And I understand that you have to make it small. But I just need to show y'all. Okay, yeah, this is it. Look, my camera can't even show you. That's how small it is. Okay? That's an issue. That's an issue. I mean, kind of. But look, anybody can repair a product. Draw you. How much money you got? Look, I'm just dissing capitalism. I'm dissing capitalism right now. All right, guys. Twitch's music program thing just crashed. What the fuck? Literally, I hate the people at Twitch that do this. That literally make their products and their applications fucking do this. Where I literally have to open up and just end the task. Okay. Oh, Jesus, politics. What channel is that from? What is that? Yeah, I know. I've been doing a lot of politics. And we're talking about products and planned obsolescence. But here's the thing, is that a lot of people under the current system of capitalism can't afford nice products. So they have to buy cheap. You like my new setup? Thank you. This isn't loud enough. Okay, for me. They have to buy cheap products that will break and end up in a landfill. Because they can't afford nice products. And it's still profitable to sell these cheap garbage products. because they'll still sell, because you need certain products if you have something. If you don't believe in global warming, I can't have a conversation with you. Because obviously you're not interested in the scientific method, and you're not interested in science. And you're not interested in the well-being. Or you're not interested in the well-being of the human race. So because I believe in global warming and climate change, now believe in global warming, because I believe we should make good products that are sustainable and that will last a long time. He doesn't stand for the American people, obviously. We did not vote him in. Hey, Kay, are you still here? Kay, are you still here? Exactly. He doesn't speak for me, and he doesn't speak for this country. You know, he really doesn't speak for this country because he didn't win the popular vote. Here's the voting system that I want. I want ranked choice voting. So here's what you do in a ranked choice voting. You rank your politicians. Let's say we got Byrne. We got Cam. We got Obama. Yes, and the Republican Party uses voter suppression tactics. This would make representation so much better. This would make representation look. Are you the streamer? Cupid, you're not the streamer. I'm the streamer. I get to talk about my ideas. If you want to talk about your ideas, go make a YouTube channel. That's probably a better idea to get them out. Because they're not just there live. Because no one watches VODs. There's a reason I'm doing there's a reason I do politics. It's because it gets views. And it's because this is what I believe. And I want to share that with the world. Alright? Yes, we imagine a better future so that we can work towards it. This is possible. This right here is possible. You can do this. This can be done on a local level. This can be done on a local level. If there's anything possible out of any of this, it's ranked choice voting.
Yeah, we poked you with sticks till you fell down. Remember?
You sure I didn't harness the power of the sun?
No, it's definitely sticks. Beating with sticks.
Alright, go get them.
Just reinstate Obama. Obama's not good. All of our presidents are, all of our presidents are war criminals, okay? Even Trump. He did a bad by creating a power vacuum in the Middle East. Which, you know, I don't... If we didn't have troops there in the first place, it wouldn't really be that much of a problem. Yeah, by the way, it would also... He already served 2 terms.
Not there. Ow!
Are you still here?
Free healthcare? Yeah. Yeah, he did not. He's not that good. He's really not that lovely of a guy.
I thought the show was over.
It started?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Oh, okay.
He was a lovely guy. What? I mean, sure. Alright, so after we get everyone all these things, then, well, after we give everyone their necessities, then, well, I think maybe only homeless people and people unfortunate, then we can give everyone. Food. Roof. Healthcare. What's Obamacare? Okay, so Obamacare is very complicated. It is very, very, very complicated. I cannot go over the ACA because I'm just a streamer, okay? These are just some of the ideas that I believe, some of the ideas that I want to put out there. And I'm not even, like, I like the fact that y'all watch me. But it's not, so here we instate this for people unfortunate, you know, only people who are unfortunate get all this stuff to get them on their feet. Obamacare is very complicated, and it's not that good. But it did do a good couple things. Healthcare, by the way, this would replace private healthcare. No more private healthcare. Fuck private healthcare. This would make a public option. This would make a public option. So, we move slowly left. But then this would destroy the public option. Or the private option of private healthcare. Good thing the U.S. has enough money and you can build infrastructure. So everyone gets food, everyone gets roof, everyone gets healthcare, everyone gets internet. That's the next thing. After that, you know, some things will fall apart, okay? So here's the thing. When this happens, some people will quit their job. Okay, and that's fine. You know why that's fine? Because that job was bad. When people are given the option to survive, without a job? Where am I from? Or where is Cupid from? Cupid's from the UK. Your previous rulers, Lamau. Because if you quit your job, because you now have the means to survive without a job, that job is trash. So certain industries will probably fall apart. But that's fine. What will fall apart? That's what I'm wondering. Germany has an excellent welfare system. This is what I want for this country. This is what I want for this country. This is what I believe will work. And probably about here is where we need $15 minimum wage. And I'm not really for minimum wage, but we don't have any, But the thing is, we don't have any, unions. Union. Like, fast food might fall apart if this gets instated. Will that be a bad thing? Union as in worker unions. Fast food might fall apart, which will be good. For the environment. Cubicle jobs might be gone. What do you even do in a cubicle? Why do we need that work? Terrible idea, abolish the unions. Yeah. I think the fuck not. Cubicle jobs might not exist. Make people happy. But you know what will happen? What will take place is that people can be creative. They can make art. They can make art. I don't know what I'm drawing. Art. They can code. They can learn a new language. They can get an education. Oh yeah, also like literally free college. How many paid statutory? I don't even know what that means. Probably zero. But here's the thing. This is what I want for the United States. And if you're lazy, if you're lazy. That's fine. And when I say healthcare, I also mean mental health. Okay? So if you're lazy, that's fine. But this won't happen for everyone. And dental and vision. Dental and vision? Who the fuck decided that that's separate? Okay? That's fine. Most people will still want a job. What does a job do? But you know what jobs won't exist? Non-fulfilling jobs. Non-fulfilling jobs will no longer exist. What do you mean, y'all? Unions are good, okay? Unions are good for the workers. And anti-unionism is also based in racism. So, jobs that will fulfill you, give you a reason to survive, a reason to live. That you enjoy. That provides betterment of society. Okay? This is what I want. That won't happen. Look, if you want to clean your house, you have plenty of time. You have plenty of time to clean your house. You know why? Because all of this exists. Are you saying there will be people that won't want to be construction workers? I doubt that. Yeah, I doubt that. Construction workers will still exist. Trust me. It's a job that I believe is fulfilling. good, even. And with new regulations in place, and with worker co-ops, it will also have... What if this plan does happen? If this plan does happen, I would be very happy. If this plan does happen, does take place, the right will be like, what happened? Why is this country so great? You know? Do you realize how many issues you fix by just going here in the plan? So, right now, about here, we live in what I like to call market socialism plus. Plus floor. Okay? So money still exists. If a sector is in high demand, it will pay well. Okay? Yeah, also, we could automate the field. Have you ever had a Roomba? It's not very good, but, you know. Trust me, this won't happen. I promise you, the whole world's gonna catch on fire. Because of climate change. Because we're not doing anything to stop these companies from fucking up the earth. I just don't want to be a doomer. I want to bring happiness and goodness to this earth. Yeah, what sector will have no workers? This isn't like the end. We could go further left to a gift economy. But yeah. Since we're still at market socialism plus a floor, the floor plan, floor gang. Construction, sanitation will probably pay very well. Unions are good. Yeah, and after we abolish private healthcare, right about here is where we can abolish/convert. Privately owned companies. Because fair pay isn't fair pay. Hey, Levo. Levo comes in here and this is what I show. Oh my god. We're doing fine. Levo comes in. Zooms out of master plan. Zooms out of agenda. Guys, this is the left-wing agenda. I was explaining how... how we could fundamentally change by moving our country further left. And I want this to happen in other countries as well. Like, you know, all around the world. Are you saying unions don't work? Bro, okay. So let me explain to you something about the US. We have something called right to work. We have something called right to work legislation. Which basically destroys unions. Unions? No. Bad. It's bad for the bourgeoisie. And then as well as makes it very, very hard to fight against wrongful firing. Excellent. Artie likes the bourgeoisie. You freaking bootlicker, bro. Guys, Cupid's a bootlicker. Yeah, by the way, you better not stop supporting me because you don't agree with my political beliefs. Bootlicking is based. Ugh! Ugh, Levo. Okay, so... wrongful firing. It makes it very hard to fight against wrongful firing. And right to work legislation. If the boot steps on fascists. Based? So yeah, under like market socialism plus floor. Sanitation and high demand industries would pay well. Which means they could have, you know, even better goods, I guess. But also, they would have time to spend with their family. You know? And over here is gift economy, which would be definitely a much more further left. Unions influence or attempt to... What was that? I'm sorry, my stuff is really, not the best. Unions don't have the direct power to- Exactly. But you know who does? You know who does have that direct power? Oh my god, so many arrows from the bourgeoisie. You know who does have the power to affect change? Is the bourgeoisie. The people at the very, 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 very tippy top of the pyramid. They put billions with a B. Billions of dollars into Washington to get their things changed. Yo, I forgot how good I was at art. Revolution, please. Here's the thing. Oh my goodness. The Vanguard Party release, influence alls. Yeah. Look, these people, they deserve to be taxed. The amount of money that they have is immense. And it could literally change the world. If you believe in money as a concept, even though, you know, it's not fucking real. If you believe in money as a concept, there's no reason to have this much money when people are piss poor. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You don't deserve to have this much money when people are starving on the streets. You don't deserve to have a super yacht. You do not deserve to have a super yacht. What is this? Okay. Bro, that's a good looking yacht. Guys, I'm such an artist. So, like, when I'm not even trying to do art, why is it good? But when I'm trying to do art, it's terrible. I don't understand. Rich people also provide jobs for the working class, piss them off and scare them away. No changes to the poor. Look. You really want to... I just want to show you how bad the inequality is between the rich and the poor. The rich and the poor? Yeah. Literally, corporations won't leave us if we literally stop them from doing business with us, with America. Okay? Yeah, imagine thinking markets are good. Tell Apple? Look, I already told Apple. Here's how I told Apple. That I'm not buying their products. I'm not buying Boston Dynamics. Look, here's the thing. My name almost never shows up. Me talking on the internet, pseudo-anonymously, is different than me showing up in public and being like, yo, market is bad.